Okay, shall we proceed? Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Salam sejahtera untuk kita semua. Om Swastiastu, Namo Buddhaya, salam kebajikan dan salam sehat. Very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and also the participants from class International Look as Nyebusonya. I don't know the series of number. Okay, today we have the brown bag discussions made by the Philip J. Jisap Moot Court participants in the 2021. So today we have Arimbi Bajri as one of the seasoned mooters or the experienced mooters. He just already joined in the Moot Court competition in national round in 2020, and then also will join again in the global round, international round in the 2021 in March. So we will compete 600 universities all over the world from the 90 countries all over the world itself. So today it is like the season for them as the visiting student to share their thought regarding the international law particularly, and also talking about the case or mode problem of ISAP competition. As we know, Philip J. Jisap Moot Court competition is the highest and prestigious competitions for the international law issues. And today we will talk about one issues regarding to the state sovereignty and also how the implications or how the state sovereignty issue happening in the Moot Problem 2021. Without further ado, before I over the microphone and the share screen to Arimbi Bajri, we will proceed this event by watch the video first. Enjoy the video. Alright, I will begin this panel sessions by give the microphone to RNB and also the share screen. RNB will talk about the state sovereignty under the international law in the 30 meter head, and then we go to the second part. It be the question and answer session, so you can ask RNB by using Bahasa or English, both of us okay, by turn on your microphone or just use the raise hand button picture under your share screen, and also maybe you can write your question down when you don't want to speak directly to RNB by using the column chat in your Zoom in your Zoom tools. So without further ado, I will offer the microphone and the share screen to RNB. RNB, please.
Okay, I would like to start my share screen now first. Is my screen?
Yes, we can see that clearly.
Wait. Right, I will start. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Very good afternoon, everybody. Thanks to giving me opportunity and time to doing the Brownback discussion about state sovereignty. The first, I would like to say special thanks to Ibu Sonia because this is her class, and Mrs. Ari Wiryadinata, of course, as coaches of Philip C. Jisab 2021. Before I talk a lot, I would like to introduce myself first. My name is RNB Fajari Furqon, and now I'm on my fourth year student. This is the last year in University Bengkulu, I mean, and I'm the late of member of delegate Philip C. Jisab 2020, and now I'm the delegate of Philip C. Jisab 2021. So the material that I would like to discussion to you about the state sovereignty, but before I talk about the material, I would like to show you the outline of today. The first is a general principle of law, and the second is state sovereignty and sovereign rights, and the third is case concerning to 2021. Let's restart our discussion. The first is a general principle of law. The general principle of law, as we know, is one of a source of international law. The Soviet writer Stankin subscribed to this approach regarding the general principle of law as reiterating the fundamental precept of international law. For example, the law of peaceful, which have already been set out in the treaty and custom law. And the next is general principle of law as a one of source of international law laid down in Article 38 of International Court of Justice recognized by civilized nation. But guys, nowadays the civilized nation is a definition like a pure definition, because civilized nation by a developed country like United States of America, Germany, France. But many jurists now argue that maybe there are a civilized nation among the country like not include the developed country. For example, Asian nation maybe, or Indian nation that have a general principle of law too. For the example of general principle of law, as you know, is a familiar principle. The first is state responsibility. This is a fundamental general principle because provide that a state that violate international law have to obligate to hold the accountable of its action, guys. So This is according the nation of the state responsibility, the international that is obligate to immediately an illegal that injure about the other parties. And the second is pacta sunt servanda. This is, I mean, is very familiar to you because this is the one of contract principle, the principle of contract, and in international law, in the treaties. Principle drawn in Visalti 1969 and obligate to parties that the treaty must obey the regulation of the treaties, guys, and legally binding by parties of the treaty itself. And the third is on your screen, good faith principle. This is so familiar too. The good faith is fairly and in good faith and do not destroy the right of the other parties of the treaties, guys. And the fourth is erga omnes. The erga omnes is the fundamental principle. This means when a state or a state make a treaties and comply erga omnes principle, the third states must obey to the erga omnes too. For example, the regulation about the genocide, slavery, piracy, and racial discrimination. And move to the state sovereignty. Have you ever heard about the state sovereignty? I think if you join international law class, it is the principle that very, 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 very familiar to you. Next. Yes, move to the state sovereignty. It is a material today, a key material today. Sovereignty is a relation between states, mean independence. So sovereignty is close to independence of the state, guys. Independence in relation to the area of the globe is a right to exercise his function within the state, excluding any other state. So excluding any other state means the independence of the state right to do not interference by the other state. And moreover, the dissenting opinion of Judge Alvarez in the Corfu Channel case state that sovereignty is defined as a state of the right and attributes and possessed by the state in its territory, including any other state, and also in his relation with other state. So the sovereignty means that every state have a relation, even the domestic relation or international relation. They have a sovereignty to do that. And moreover, the declaration on the principle of international law concerning friendly relation and cooperate among states in accordance with the Charter of the UN on 1970 state that each state has an inalienable right to choose its political, economic, social, and cultural system without interference in any form by any whatever of other state. It drawn to in the Montevideo Convention, if you ever heard, in the Montevideo Convention Article 8 state that no one state can interfere the other relation of state, like domestic internal relation or internal sovereignty and external relation with the other states. And we move to categorize the sovereignty. This categorize is very close to territorial sovereignty, and the jurisdiction is keen to be separate because they are united maybe, and we move to the land sovereignty. the judge of Haber, not in the, in Palma's case, that sovereignty to a portion of the surface of the globe is a legal condition necessary for the conclusion of such portion in the territory of any particular state. The territorial of land area of the state categorized as a sovereignty. A state has jurisdiction to apply the law, control of all activities in the territorial, such as the criminal law, politics, economics, people, and so on and so forth. But this is a limited about the state sovereignty and the land sovereignty that every state can comply all the controlling of the what I said before, like criminal law, politics, economics, and people, but they must obey the international obligation and the international principle I said before. So the sovereignty is full, but it is not a full to be limited like that. And there are basically two methods by which a new entity may gain its independence as a new state. So this is independence of land sovereignty. The first by constitutional means, like Indonesia become independent and gain a, and make a constitutional and give in the constitutional about the territorial of Indonesia itself, and the second is by non-constitutional and usually by force. This is illegal in international law because the use of force is not in line with the Article 2 of United Nations that international community must maintain peace and security. And the equation of the any additional territory in the classical technique of categorizing the various modes and of equation. This is based on Roman law. There are five modes of equation are usually detailed. The first is occupation of terra nullius. The key material in this point is a terra nullius. So the land is without a private property or without the sovereignty of other state. There are two kinds of aspect in the occupation of terra nullius. The first is subjective and the second is objective. The objective is close to terra nullius and the land must without a private property and sovereignty of the other state, and the second is the sovereignty of the state to occupy the land itself, and the second is a prescription, the sovereignty transfer of the territory by the open and encroachment by a new sovereign upon the territory of prolonged period of time. This is a many practice in the state among international community, and the third is cession. This involves the peaceful transfer of territory from one sovereign to another. So the bold is the peaceful transfer. Maybe Indonesia want to transfer the territorial or the yes the territorial to the other state, and we can have been a cession. And the third is accretion. This describes the geographical process. This is a geographical process, and naturally by which new land is formed and becomes attached to extended land. As for example, the creation of island in the river boat or the chain in the direction of a boundary river leaving dry land where it had formal float. And the last is conquest. This is I mentioned before by force, but this term is illegal by international law nowadays because UN Charter had regulate about every state or every party of UN have to maintain the peace and security even in the domestic sovereignty and relation with the other country. Next, we move to law on the sea about the sovereignty. This is three kind of sovereignty. The first is a full sovereignty, as you see in the territorial sea, and we can count it from the baseline, and 12 miles from the baseline is a territorial sea. This is a sea with full sovereignty for the country. It's laid too in the Article 3 of UNCLOS that every state has the right to establish the breadth of its territorial sea up to a limit not extending 12 nautical miles. Measured from a baseline determined in accordance with a convention. So the count able of the territorial sea about 12 nautical miles from a baseline, and this is a full sovereignty of a state. And the second is a contiguous zone and exclusive economic zone. This is a sovereignty, but this is a kind of sovereign right. You know that sovereign right is we can exploiting, conserving, managing living or non living resource in the exclusive economic zone and contiguous zone. But we also respect the regulation of international law. So move to the continental south. This is a 200 nautical miles from the baseline, but many jurists in the journal, in the book, say that the continental south can be until 350 to the deep seabed. So the continent, many jurists that argue continental south is not with exclusive economic zone, but can longer than exclusive economic zone from above 350 nautical miles from the seabed to the deep seabed baseline to the deep seabed. And the continental south itself first is proclaimed by US President Harry Truman. So he said that the jurisdiction to control continental south is a jurisdiction of the coastal state. So about her proclamation in the UNCLOS 1982, regulate about this about the continental self categorized as sovereign rights with Article 77 of UNCLOS regarding the continental self. Next, we can move to high seas and deep seabed. But first, but before I take a material about high seas and deep sea bit, I want to talk about internal water first. Internal waters is respected by UNCLOS, of course, and the internal water have a full sovereignty, including the site of the baseline of a nation territorial that is facing towards the land except in archipelagic state. It includes waterways such as rivers, canals, and sometimes the water within a small bays like that. Then it is a full sovereignty. we can move to the airspace and outer space law, because my friend Faiha talk a lot about the airspace and outer space in the Saturday, so you can enjoy the material from Faiha about the airspace and outer space completely. So I just make an outline. The airspace, the first, in the airspace we have a full sovereignty. It is a light drawn by a 1919 Paris Convention for the Regulation of Aerial Navigation, which recognized the full sovereignty of a state over the airspace above their land and territorial sea. And it in line too with the Chicago Convention about the Civil Aviation, 1944, in Article 6, reinforced that by providing that no schedule international air service may be operated over or into the territory of a contracting state. So it clear that in a airspace we have a full sovereignty, and if an aliens aircraft wanna join our territory, they must have the permission for our country. It reflects the full sovereignty of the state in the airspace. Move to the outer space. The United Nations General Assembly Resolution 1962 and adopt in 1963. From a declaration of legal principle governing the activities of state in exploration of the use of outer space, lay down a series of applicable legal principles which include the provision that outer space and celestial bodies were free for exploration and use by all states on a basis of equality and accordance with international law. This is controversial regulation because Indonesia itself in our constitutional state that outer space belongs to us, but in the international community outer space is no one state can belonging outer space, guys. So but in the outer space we can explore and we can go to there by a principle first come first serve. This principle is very close to outer space, not very close. This is a regulation one of regulation in the outer space. The means of self first is if we want to explore the outer space such as our satellites or orbital of satellites, maybe we have to be in a waiting list. So the first who come to the outer space with the good technology have to first serve to explore the outer space. This is my material about general material about the state sovereignty. We can move to the case. This is a practice cases in International Court of Justice. The first case is I take from Pulau Batu Putih, Middle Rocks, between Malaysia and Singapore in 2008. The court first indicated that had original title to Pulau Batu Putih, a granite island which like Holstein belong to Malaysia. This original title belongs to Malaysia. But when the dispute crystallized in 1918, the title of Pulau Batu Putih passed to Singapore, as attested by a conduct of a parties. So the Singapore is like Malaysia in Sipadan Ligitan case. I think you understand what I say about the Sipadan Ligitan, that an island become a Malaysian territorial. In particular, certain acts performed by a Singapore attire the saffron and the flair of Malaysia to react the conduct of Singapore. So the Malaysia didn't react about the act of Singapore. So the court said that this Pulau Batu Putih belongs to Singapore, and the court consequently award the sovereignty over Pulau Batu Putih to Singapore. And but in a like a granite island have a middle rocks, a maritime feature consisting of several rocks permanently above water. The court observed that particular circumstances which had led to find that sovereignty over Pulau Batu Putih raised with Singapore clearly didn't apply to middle rocks. So the Pulau Batu Putih is award sovereignty to Singapore, but the middle rocks is belongs to Malaysia. It therefore found that Malaysia should be considered to have retained original title of Middle Rocks. So the court concluded that the sovereignty over South Ledge, Middle Rocks to the state is whose territorial waters it lies, so the territorial of Malaysia. This is above a full sovereignty that we have to respect principle of international law, that principle effectivities of a sovereignty. So Singapore did it like a Malaysian did to the Sipadan Ligitan. Move to the second case. This is about a criminal case in the sovereignty or in the territorial of U.S. This case is mentioned as a lagrun between Germany and United States of America in 2001. This case is between Germany people who have a German nationality, the two criminal that died a court of U.S. having their died to death to execute the criminal, but the U.S. authority not inform any of consulate in the consulate of Germany in the U.S. territorial. So the Germany state that the authorities of the state of Arizona, two German nationals, Carl and Walter, and said we can say Lagren, who have tried and sentenced to death without having been informed of their right under Vienna Convention on the Consular. And Germany also alleged that the failure to provide the required notification precluded the Germany from protecting its national interests. So the Germany have to protect their national interests, such as criminal that are executed by U.S. It is provide or light in Article 5 and 36 of the Vienna Convention and Vienna Convention on the Consular, but the trial and appeal level in the United States court. And Lagrange have the right to the consulate of Germany notified, but their arrest about their arrest. So the two people have arrested, but didn't notify to the consulate of Germany, and two German national were executed by United States. I mean, sorry. But the Germany America or United States to respect the Vienna Convention itself. So with respect to the Germany's request, seeking the assurance that the United States will not repeat its unlawful acts. So this is categorized as a unlawful acts. Execute the other national to our national to our state without a notified before. And the court took a note of the fact that the letter had repeatedly stated in all parts of those proceedings that it was implementing a phased and detailed program in order to ensure compliance by its competent authorities with Article 36 the Convention, and conclude that the commitment must be regarded as a meeting and request met by Germany. But the court conclude that the United States, notwithstanding that the commitment, if were to fail again of its obligation of consular notification to the German nationals, an apology from the United States is apologized to the Germany authority, and if it's become again or twice, apology will not survive in a case where the individuals concerned had been subjected to prolonged detention or convicted and sentenced to several penalties. So guys, this is a right in the sovereignty of United States, but we have to respect the other regulation or the other regulation of international law too. For make it clear, I would like to tell you about the human right, respect to the country that subject of international respect to the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. And there, we have to know that the arrest and detention of people must be notified with its nationality. And we can move to the case concerning 2021 GSAP competition. So I have drawn and light down the case, the summary of facts. This is a aircraft incident, actually a civil aircraft incident. So the regulation is under international law about the Chicago Convention. Apre Pluya is a state, yeah. Apre Pluya shoot down the civil aircraft with its nationality in territorial of Apre Pluya. So Apre Pluya shoot down the civil aircraft named Mentian Airways in territorial of Apre Pluya by military aircraft. This case is above a Mentian Airways. The nationality of Mentian Airways is Apre Pluya. So this is a civil aircraft of Apre Pluya, and flying illegally without permission and didn't respond to the radio call from a military aircraft. This is a kind of error from a radio call from the Mentian Airways, so the pilot can hear what the Apre Pluya institution said in the radio call. And the pilot and passenger was found died in the forest of a near capital city of Apulia. So when they want to fly to a capital city and in a royal palace, the maintenance always shut down by Apulia, and the pilot and the passenger was found died. So I want to ask you, if you want to answer, just open your mic and just say it, what your answer. How sovereignty applied in this case, guys? Do you want to answer? Hello? Anyone? Okay, like... I will like to continue the presentation. So the state sovereignty in this case is limited under international law. This is some kind of a United States case before. And why this is limited under international law? The first is the convention to establish the non-use of force as a principle regulating in international relation. This is what I said before under Article 2 of UN Charter that and it is laid down to in the Nicaragua case that it is a principle about the non-use of force in international law. And the second is state sovereignty regarding to the principle of good neighbor lines. So guys, the principle of good neighbor lines is a state that no one state in their territory can do the action with the impact with the other state or the neighbor state. So this is some type of a limit of state sovereignty. We can do whatever we want in our sovereignty, like we build the tower, or we can have a flying drone in our state. But if what we act is have an impact to the other states, this is a violate under international law, and the state must responsible to their action to the neighbor state maybe, or the other state that have be impacted. And the third is a fundamental right according to the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. Everyone has the right to live, liberty, and security person. If we say that if we shut down in anything in our territory and they are died, so this is an violate of international law, because Universal Declaration of Human Rights have regulate about everyone has the right to live, liberty, and security person. And the third is the fourth or the last argument is the regulation of this Chicago Convention on International Civil Aviation in Article 3b. This is a state that a state can use same with the first argument, can use a force or weapons against a civil aircraft, even if this is a military aircraft that shoot. It is a very violent under international law. Move to the second fictive case.
5 minutes left, RMB.
Yes, this is the last The entry regulation of Ranovstayo in emergency situation. The case is about Ranovstayo as independent state applied the entry regulation under domestic law considered the pandemic COVID-18. COVID-18 is some kind of COVID-19 in real life. This is like a fictive case. And the WHO categorized this virus as a pandemic, and the regulation of Ranovstayo entry restriction even the civil aircraft transit. And because the time is came so this is a kind of full sovereignty, guys. So the Montevideo Convention state that no state has the right to intervene the internal or external affairs of another. So the internal and external affairs of Ranovstayo can be intervened by any state. And the second is state sovereignty of Ranovstayo has thus authority of Ranovstayo jurisdiction and didn't discriminate appropriate by apply entry regulation. And the third is considered to Article 1 of a Chicago Convention, said that the contracting state recognized that every state has complete and exclusive sovereign over the airspace above its territory, and in line with Salus Populi Suprema Lex Esto. Okay, guys. That's all about my presentation about the material of sovereignty. If you have a question, you can see.
Wait. Okay, thank you so much. Are you already finished? Dismiss your presentations or not, Arinbi?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Can you share off your screen, please?
What?
Can you share off your share screen? Okay. Okay. Thank you so much for your fruitful discussions as well as your nice and super complete presentations regarding the state sovereignty under the international law. I think we already have three questions in the chat box. Maybe yes. I will read these questions for you. Guys, the questions in Indonesia is okay, but RNB have to answer the questions by using English because it is like the practice situation.
I will try.
First question, maybe the easy one, from Tiara Citrabella. They asked about the status of general principle of law as the source of international law, because we know that there are so many source of international law stated by the Article 38, first or paragraph 1 in the International Court of Justice status. So what is the status of general principle of law itself? It is the first question, RNB. A second question coming from Randy Agus at Tinda. They asked regarding the issue of how the international law see or perspective about the state who not purely independent, I mean that the like half independence, where their sovereignty always being distracted by the another country over there. The next question is about from Wendy Francisca. They ask about what is the functions and the purpose of permissions of the Outer Space Treaty 1967. I think it is the first sessions of the questions and answer. Oh, still have one. You have four questions. From Vertia also, I want to ask, is there a fundamental difference between the principle of sovereignty and sovereign rights? She asked about what is the difference between the sovereignty and sovereign rights. And then also another questions, I think it will be the next season for the Ali Purnama. Okay, please give your short and brief comment or answer for three first questions.
Okay, thank you for a very much question, and thank you very much to respond to my presentation. The first I want to ask sir is from Tiara Citrabella, the general principle of law as a source of international law. In the UN, in the ICJ statute, the source of international law, such as a treaties, general principle of law, what doctrine or jurisprudence. So, the good question is, where the general principle in the source of international law? The source of international law has a soft law and a hard law. The general principle of law is in the hard law because this is a regulation or this is a general principle that respected by international community. So the hard law is treaties and the second is general principle of law and custom. So Tiara Citrabella, can you understand about my answer or I have to elaborate more?
Tiara, do you have any comments about her response or her answering, or is it enough?
Thank you.
Okay, maybe we can go to the second questions, R&B.
Yes. From Randy, about a state that independency is not completely. So what the sovereignty in their territorial, right? Based on my knowledge, if a state not completely independent and the international community belum mengakui the state itself, so it can be said that the state is not independent. So, if you said that, but international law, it respect to the sovereignty of independence of the state. Like this is if we said like a belligerent, this is one kind of subject of international law, and if I'm not an independent country can minta pengampuan to the other country that want to cover their rights in international law. We move to the third question. The function of Outer Space Treaty 1967 from Windy. The function of the treaties in general is to being a source of international law. So the function of the formation of the Outer Space Treaty is regulate about the multilateral treaties that regulate about outer space, and it become a lawmaking treaties in international community. The lawmaking treaties is when a treaty is legally binding by the other state or by a third state that do not ratify, but it can be source of international law about outer space treaty. This is drawn by an what principle I said before about first come, first serve. And this is the regulation in the treaty is come from the outer space treaty itself. So the international community can take the source of international regulation from the treaty itself. And
it is the last question from Ali Purnama, I think the final questions about the what if an island nation have a part of the strait that was closer to the mainland and there was a sea road separating the land from an island, but the part of the sea was previously a right of peaceful passage. Does the country have full sovereignty? I think it is about the status of the, for example, the Malacca Strait and so on and so forth, the strait used for the international route.
Yes. Before I answer the Ali Purnama question, in the above have a Fertia question, Bang, about fundamental difference between sovereignty and sovereignty rights and Ajinugraha. Okay, I would like to answer the Fertia R question. The difference
between sovereignty and sovereign right.
Of course, the difference of sovereignty and sovereignty right we can see today is the principle of sovereignty is a full sovereignty. So we can control our state. If we Indonesia, we can control the territorial of Indonesia about the law, about a social, politics, and economic and a criminal. It is out from the interference of the other state. But if we have a sovereign right, like in an economic zone, in the continental south, we can just exploitation and we can make like a tambang just for it, for economically. So we can make a control to the political, to the law maybe, but we can secure our territorial from the sovereign right area, like our military in there. So we there are a protect to the territorial of a state itself. And the Ajinugraha question, no. I think no, the question is has a sovereignty in yes, and in air space, but no in outer space. So the sovereignty in air space is full sovereignty, but we must respect the other general rules of international law. And about the about a question from Ali Purnama, full sovereignty, but we can see many aliens ship are go to the Malacca, maybe to the full sovereignty of us. So this is regulation from UNCLOS. This is a state as a not peaceful passage. I forget, Bang. What peaceful passage? Not a peaceful passage in international law set as yes, like the other state. The other state ship or the other state aircraft can go to our sovereignty and to our full sovereignty territorial with peacefully. So they must do peacefully and continuously. This is a kind of a full sovereignty, but we have to respect to the unclosed, about the sea and to the Chicago Convention about the airspace, because we as a country ratified this convention. So yes, a good, very good question from Muhammad Fadil about sovereignty of a state if taken by the other state, maybe. Yes, the state sovereignty can go out from the state because of what I said before, like occupation and use of force and like I said before in my presentation, in a land sovereignty, the sovereignty can take over to the other country, maybe on the belligerents, like a belligerents have a territorial itself to go out from the other state, from the state sovereignty, and the community in their land or their territory have to choose what they want. In Paris 2018, I said like I just forget. And the last question to Germany national, it is about the case. Thank you for the question. The two Germany national commit a crime or a national crime of United States, so they were executed by a court of United States. So if we said this is a jurisdiction territorial, so the United States applied to jurisdiction territorial. They execute the Germany national that commit crime in their territory. This is a right, but it's not full right. Like Indonesia executed an Australian about the drugs last year or yes. Okay.
Enough, RMB. Okay, thank you so much for the questions from the participants. Super nice and enthusiastic, I think. I don't know how many participants from this class because it's quite relatively lower than another participants from another class. But the question is a very huge, pretty huge number coming from this class. So maybe for each of you who already asked the questions, you will get the spot, you will get the souvenir pin and also the sticker sponsored by KPK. So maybe the counting can get the sticker and also the pin. Just contact me along this this week, because after the Christmas we will have the long vacations or long holiday. Again, thank you so much for your participations and your contributions in this brown bag discussions. We say that brown bag terminologically, it means that the informal discussions, informal meeting between the millennials to talk about any issues, particularly in these occasions we talk about the international law, particularly or especially about the state sovereignty. Again and again, thank you so much for your participation and see you. Terima kasih semuanya.
Thank you guys.
Boleh di screenshot ya ininya buat absen di kelasnya Bu Ong, nanti dikirim ke emailnya Bu Ong masing-masing seperti biasa. Terima kasih.
Thank you. Bye bye. See you.
Siapa nga SS ko?